Hi, I'm Prateek Singh from Market Scientist TV, and welcome to another episode. Today, we are going to learn about market direction. Now, it's very interesting because everyone keeps coming up with this question, will the markets rise or will the markets fall? Well, using just a few technical tools, and I'm not talking about indicators, just pure price action, we can actually determine market direction. Now, market direction is actually referred to in the technical world as trends. So, a stock moving upwards is in an uptrend, and a stock moving downwards is in a downtrend. Sometimes stocks reach in a no trade zone or a sideways, and this happens because as soon as markets go up, it forces a situation of supply, and markets fall down or break down, forcing a situation of demand coming in. This was seen in the earlier half of December 2012 on the Nifty charts, if you could find or get your hands on them. Let's move on. When we use concepts of supply and demand over very long periods of time, you must realize that psychology exists on all time frames. Except, of course, the tick charts where you have volume, markets will always behave in the same way if your concept is technically sound. So let's look at how you can become your own amateur financial analyst, determining whether your stock that you're stuck in or making a profit might continue to move up or might continue to move down. So the first thing we're going to learn is about a rally and a decline. A rally and decline are seen on a per bar basis, meaning we're looking at only one bar and the next. Simply put, a rally is simply an up move and a decline is simply a down move. They together form something more important, which we'll discuss later. Let's look at a rally first. So this is one bar. This doesn't give us enough information. The next bar breaks the previous bar's high, and this continues to happen. Now you'll notice that every bar, every consecutive bar, is breaking the previous bar's high, and it's also having a higher low. This means that the market is in rally mode. Also remember, in a real market situation, it may not happen consecutively, but a general move up is still considered a rally. A decline now is just the opposite. And I'm sure intuitively you've understood what I'm about to draw here. So the market falling down each consecutive bar, breaking the previous bar's low, and making a lower low every bar. So that's very simple. Here is another rally which makes a new high, and here is another decline. Right. So now that we have that, you can see that we have formed a wave structure. Markets will always move in waves. Markets will never plunge down or move up unless it's an erratic day or days. Over general long periods of time, markets will always move in waves, and this is very, very healthy. So now that we've understood a rally and decline, let's move on to something more interesting. A swing high and a swing low. Simply put, the meeting point of a rally, an up move, and the meeting point of the immediate decline, this tent or this mountain or this peak, is a swing high, right? The opposite of this is a swing low, meaning the meeting point of a decline and the meeting point of a rally is a swing low. Now, trends are made up of swing highs and swing lows. People call these by different names, but all technicals follow this because a swing high is a natural place of resistance. It basically means that the markets rallied, hit a supply point, either buying diminished or too much supply came in or too much selling happened, and we fell. Now, the longer time frame between a swing high is untouched, the more important it becomes. At Market Scientist, we follow trend following systems. So what we're discussing in this video and the next is extremely important. If you don't understand, please rewind, or you can ask questions by emailing us or writing it in the comments below. So here is a real example of a chart. This chart belongs to Nifty, and it's basically in a downtrend. But what we have to look now is for the swing highs and swing lows. I want you to take a moment and try to find the latest swing highs that you can see here. Now I'm helping you a bit and marking all of the swing highs on this chart. I've marked them with green lines, green circles. The next step is to identify swing lows. Now before we proceed, I want you to pause and take your time to look at the swing highs and know that you've understood this. We're basically looking for peaks, which are called swing highs, and crests, which are called swing lows. I'm marking the first two swing lows for you, and I want you to mark the rest in your head or write it down somewhere. Pause this video, find out all the swing lows on this chart, and we will meet in the next video with the answers. I'll be waiting for you then, so see you there.